how to add a Ken Burns effect using pan and zoom in VideoPad. To add a pan and zoom effect, often known as a Ken Burns effect, to a video clip, click the FX button in your clip on the timeline to open the effects dialog. Click plus and select pan and zoom. On the clip preview, use the widget to position and size how your clip will start. Select end frame and use the widget to position and size how your clip will finish. To review the effect, check preview effect and then play the clip. To make further adjustments, uncheck preview effect to display the editing widgets again. Continue watching for additional details on how to add pan and zoom to a video clip. The pan and zoom effect will pan and zoom smoothly from the position and size of the start frame widget to that of the end frame widget. Select a clip, then add the pan and zoom effect by clicking on the FX button on the clip on the timeline, or by clicking the video effects button in the Home or Effects tab toolbar. Select pan and zoom from the effects list to add the effect to the clip. The effect opens with a widget displayed for the start frame. To adjust the frame, click and drag on one of the squares around the border. When adjusting the widgets, you will notice that the aspect ratio is kept the same as the clip. This means, for example, if you drag a side of a widget, the perpendicular sides will also move to keep the same width to height ratio. Once you have the start of the effect framed, select the radio button next to select end frame. Edit the widget to the right size and position. You can move the widget by clicking and dragging inside the frame. When you are finished, preview the effect by selecting the box next to preview effect, then click play beneath the preview window. If you are happy, you can close the effects dialog. If you want to make additional edits, deselect the checkbox next to preview effect. This allows you to edit the start frame or end frame widgets further. For more VideoPad tutorials, visit the address shown on your screen.